how to get more sulfate if you have issues with sulfite. Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Will Estes says, calcium sulfate is commonly used as a plant food. Calcium sulfate is commonly used as a plant food. There does not appear to be a supplement manufacturer making a calcium sulfate supplement for humans. Is this form of calcium beneficial for human nutrition? We have magnesium sulfate, which below levels of bowel tolerance is a source of both magnesium and sulfate. Is there some reason why calcium attached to sulfate would not absorb as well as alternate forms of calcium, such as calcium glycinate or calcium citrate? Will follows up, if I have low sulfate levels and there is some reason to believe I am not converting sulfite to sulfate efficiently, so I'm trying to find dietary sources for sulfate. I might also try to use zinc sulfate as my primary zinc supplement. Sorry, calcium sulfate is used as a supplement for plants, not a food. Okay, I'm going to pull up some notes that I have related to this subject. Hopefully I can pull them up very quickly. Okay, so first of all, if you're not converting sulfite to sulfate, that should be a molybdenum deficiency. If it's not a molybdenum deficiency, it's probably a gut microbiota problem. Could be a sulfite oxidase enzyme deficiency, of course, but I think it would be much more common that you have sulfate metabolizing bacteria in the intestines than that you have a sulfite oxidase genetic deficiency. You know, although you can never rule out like a modest impairment in that enzyme, that would not be diagnosed with anything. Can't be ruled out. But I do think it's going to be much more common that someone has a sulfur intolerance that's driven by gut microbiota. And in that case, I think you want to be very careful about the bioavailability of sulfate salts that you use, because undigestible sulfate salts will worsen the overgrowth of sulfate metabolizing bacteria in the intestines and make them worse. And so I did do a little bit of research on this. And for example, glucosamine sulfate and chondroitin sulfate, I think, are very bad forms of sulfate to use because they do have relatively poor absorption and do alter the gut microbiota in favor of sulfate metabolizing bacteria. I can't comment on the bioavailability of calcium sulfate. I don't know what its bioavailability would be. It is the case that sodium sulfate and potassium sulfate and any salt of a group one element in the periodic table is going to completely ionize in any water solution. And that's not necessarily true of other salts. So I don't know what the ionization rate of magnesium sulfate or calcium sulfate is. And if you're specifically trying to get sulfate, especially if you're worried about a gut microbiota, I do think that sodium sulfate, potassium sulfate orally, sulfur amino acids to support transsulfuration orally would be the best things to do. Now, in terms of finding sources, that's a little difficult. So, I do think that some of these things, from what I recall, I don't think you can get a food grade supplement of any of these things, but I do think that you can get, what I think you can get is food grade supplements and food grade products that are meant to be used as food additives. And I'm not sure I would trust those as being totally pure. And so I just find it unfortunate that you're not, that you can't get those. But I don't know. I have no idea why. It's probably just no one has found a marketable reason for it. And so, you know, barring, I do know that medically you can get sodium sulfate because they use it medically to for certain uses. So I'm sure you could get it prescribed and maybe get a compounding pharmacy to make it or something like that. But I don't think you can just buy it on a website. Just thinking through the easily available options, I think you want to pound the sulfur amino acid pathway because that's the best absorbed thing that you can get your hands on that has high absorption and will generate sulfate. And so NAC, for example, or just animal protein. And then, you know, if you're really trying to get around a gut problem, you could find someone to have you compounded an infusion of sulfur amino acids. Okay, so then Will follows up and says, how can my microbiome metabolize sulfate in my blood? No, I'm not saying that. It can metabolize sulfate in your food. Then he says, sulfur amino acids go through sulfite before sulfate, which is my problem I'm trying to work around. Agreed. But I'm not, so molybdenum should increase your tolerance for that. And if it's not, then I think it might be a microbiome problem. If it is a microbiome problem, then higher dose molybdenum might help because molybdenum does shut down gut microbiota metabolism of sulfur into sulfite and hydrogen sulfide. And so higher dose molybdenum than you've tried might theoretically help your tolerance of sulfur amino acids. But other than that, I don't know what to do. You can take Epsom salt baths, but the evidence on the sulfate specific absorption of them isn't good. So I have no idea how to characterize that dose. You can take magnesium sulfate to bowel tolerance. There's nothing else to do that I know of except try to find some doctor who has access to some medical grade sodium sulfate. Other than that, I think the available options are not very good, in terms of chondroitin and glucosamine. So I think it's magnesium sulfate to bowel tolerance, sulfur amino acids, try using higher dose of molybdenum to increase tolerance of them. Better identifying a potential microbiome issue in the gut. So see if you have desulfo vibrio, for example, present in the gut microbiome. So Will adds, what kind of molybdenum doses would shut down biome conversion? I don't know. I mean, I know that in vitro, molybdenum outside the culture, in the culture medium, will shut down sulfur metabolism in a sulfur metabolizing bacterium. And so presumably you want molybdenum higher than gut absorption to reach the colon. That is basically compensating for amino acids that are going to reach the colon unmetabolized. So I would, you know, start with 500 micrograms and titrate up to the tolerable upper intake level on molybdenum. So I forgot what that is off the top of my head. Oh, one second. So here we go. 2 milligrams per day is the TUA, is the upper limit for molybdenum supplementation. 2 milligrams, not 2 milligrams per day. So I would say experiment with 500 micrograms to 2 milligrams and see if that increases tolerance. That's about all I can come up with, short of finding someone that can get their hands on medical grade sodium sulfate. I know it exists because it's used to detoxify barium and stuff like that. So hope that helps, Will. Thank you for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The Masterpass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.